To me, this has got to be one of the most interesting questions. What are the Vegas Golden Knights going to do with their star goaltender? Yeah, I'm calling him that, Marc-André Fleury. Because listen, Robin Leonard, they didn't sign him to that huge deal in the offseason to go 1A, 1B with Fleury. Okay, that was not the plan. The plan was Robin Leonard's your starter, see what you can get for Fleury in the market, and we'll bring in a backup goaltender. I know it's only 7 games, but right now, Fleury's got a 934 save percentage with the Vegas Golden Knights. You guys saw the highlight reel save he made the other night, and he's just been flawless. He's been incredible every single night for the Vegas Golden Knights, keeping them in games here sometimes. So, look, he is the Fleury they got when they went to the Stanley Cup Final in their first season. And right now, you got to look at it and you say, oh boy, now we're in a predicament because we were trying to trade this guy. We all saw the Alan Walsh picture with the sword in the back, right? Dude, this is a really interesting development to this situation now because he's probably playing like your best player right now, Vegas. But is that really the plan? You want to sign Robin Leonard to that massive contract? And then you're going to keep Marc-André Fleury for this season and next season at a $7 million cap hit? I mean, I don't know. I understand the 1A, 1B thing. It's great to have a safety net so you can have two guys rolling in case one of them is struggling a little bit. But that is a heavy price to pay for a 1A, 1B. Money that I'm sure Vegas would love to spread out across the roster for different players. That could help them in many areas instead of just the goaltending position. And you ask Golden Knights fans, none of them want to lose Flower. They all love Marc-André Fleury. They don't want him to go anywhere, okay? But the reality of the situation is the management kind of picked their guy. I know they said, oh, Fleury's happy being a backup, yay. But dude, like I said, you can't have this much money just in your goaltending position. You need to spread that out across your roster, improve multiple areas of your roster. Like even if you give your second goaltender, instead of making $7 million like Fleury is, say he makes $2 million, $5 million of extra cap space would go a long way to helping you guys towards a Stanley Cup championship. And of course, we've all heard the rumors, Fleury back to Pittsburgh. And yes, there was some smoke to it a little while back, but it was the interim GM. They were just kind of checking it out, and it did almost happen in the offseason. But now we've got a completely different regime with Ron Hextall and Brian Burke. And if you've heard Brian Burke in the past few days, like I have on Sportsnet, like pretty much every day, he's saying the first priority here is to win. Because when you have guys like Crosby and Malkin in Pittsburgh, you want to win. Well, if you really want to win, I don't think Casey DeSmith or Tristan Jarry is going to get it done for you in between the pipes. So I do think they will circle back on Fleury. But that's why I'm asking this question. What are the Golden Knights going to do here? Because they need him too. And I'm sure Pittsburgh would love to have him. But right now, his value is a lot higher than it was in the offseason. And there are also some other teams. Like, for example, Edmonton. Edmonton, I'm sure, would kill for Marc-André Fleury, okay? And I understand there's some cap problems there that might not be able to get it done, but Edmonton would give you quite a lot, I think, for Marc-André Fleury, which is why I think you still, even now with how well he's playing, have to take a look at possibly trading this guy for the future of the franchise, because you could get some really good stuff for him. Like, trust me, like, Edmonton's not going to give you a Wayne Gretzky meet and greet for Marc-André Fleury. You're going to get a lot of really good assets, which is why you have to take a serious look at it. Pittsburgh as well. Pittsburgh is in a different spot because, yes, again, the priority is win. And look, Brian Burke, new president, you can tell he has a clear focus. He knows there's not maybe much time left with this core group, that being Malkin, Crosby, Letang, in Pittsburgh. So he wants to try and snag one last Stanley Cup. And Fleury would be a really strong piece to add to that. You know he's great in the room. He's got history with a bunch of guys on that team. He loved playing in Pittsburgh. He's mentioned that he would like to end his career in Pittsburgh. That's a rumor, but a rumor with some credibility. And I'm sure he feels some type of way about Vegas basically choosing Leonard over him. Okay, and yeah, I understand that, oh yeah, Fleury's happy being here, we still love him. Like, don't piss on me and tell me it's raining, okay? Like, you chose Leonard, and you're just kind of playing the field here, like, oh yeah, sure, keep Fleury, just in case, sloppy seconds type thing, okay? So I would feel some type of way too, and if I were Fleury, I'd be happy going to Pittsburgh and approving that you should have picked me instead of Leonard, just like he did with Vegas when he was trying to prove to Pittsburgh, like, hey, you made the wrong choice going with Matt Murray. I was the guy you should have gone with. So, you guys, that's it for this one. Let me know what you think. What's going to happen with Marc-Andre Fleury and the Vegas Golden Knights? Really interesting situation here. Who else would be involved, do you think? Pittsburgh? I know Edmonton would give an arm and a leg for him. Who else? Okay, those are the two biggest ones top of my head. Let me know. Like, subscribe for more daily hockey content. See you in the next one.